السلام عليكم. Good morning. My name is Raja Salim Akhtar. Welcome in this new video. Before to watch the further video, subscribe my channel, like the video, click on bell icon, share the videos. Examples of convex sets. Example 1. First part, prove that any subspace of a linear space N is convex. Second, let C be a convex subset of a linear space N. Then, for any scalar alpha, prove that alpha capital C convex subset is also convex set. Third part, prove that intersection of any class or family or collection of convex subsets of a linear space N is convex. By counter example, show that union of convex sets is not convex. Solution. First, let Y be a subspace of a linear space N. To prove subspace Y is convex, let XY belongs to subspace Y be arbitrary for any alpha belongs to closed interval 0, 1. Therefore, alpha x plus 1 minus alpha y belongs to y because y is a subspace of N and itself is also linear space. Y is closed under addition
एंड स्केलर मल्टीप्लिकेशन, दिस इंप्लाइज सबस्पेस वाई इज आल्सो कन्वेक्स, हेंस द सॉल्यूशन. सेकंड पार्ट, लेट एक्स वाई बिलोंग्स टू एल्फा कैपिटल सी एज अ कन्वेक्स सेट, बी आर्बिट्रेरी, देन देयर आर C1, C2 belongs to convex set C such that X is equal to alpha C1 and Y is equal to alpha C2. Therefore, for any lambda alpha is given, so use another notation, belongs to close interval 0 comma 1, we have lambda x plus 1 minus lambda y is equal to lambda, putting the value of x and y, alpha c1 plus 1 minus lambda alpha c2, taking alpha common, we have lambda c1 plus 1 minus lambda c2. It can be written as alpha c3, where c3 is equal to lambda c1 plus 1 minus lambda c2, and this belongs to convex set C. So this element lambda x plus 1 minus lambda y belongs to alpha c. This implies alpha c is also convex, hence the solution. Third part, let Ci such that I belongs to indexing set I be any class of convex subsets of a linear space N to prove intersection Ci, I belongs to indexing set I, is convex let x comma y belongs to intersection Ci, I belongs to I, be arbitrary, and for alpha belongs to close interval 0 comma 1, this implies x comma y belongs to Ci, for all I belongs to indexing set I, since each Ci is a convex subset of a linear space N, therefore alpha x plus 1 minus alpha y belongs to Ci for all I belongs to capital I. This implies alpha x plus 1 minus alpha y belongs to intersection I belongs to I, capital C, I. This implies intersection I belongs to indexing set I, Ci is also convex. Note, by convention, empty subset of a linear space is convex also singleton set is convex counter example for to show that union of convex sets is not convex, take subsets C1 is equal to singleton set consisting on 0 and C2 is equal to singleton set consisting on 1 are convex subsets of a linear space N, but C1 union C2 is equal to set consisting on 0 and 1 is not convex because for XY belongs to C1 union C2 and for any alpha belongs to close interval 0, 1 alpha X plus 1 minus alpha y does not belongs to C1 union C2. Hence the solution example 2. First part, prove that for any convex subsets K and L, you can use any other notation for subsets of a linear space N, or you can use other notation as V for example. The set K plus L, sum of two convex subsets, is equal to small k plus small l such that small k belongs to convex subset K and small l belongs to convex subset L is also convex. Second, let T from linear space N to linear space N be a linear transformation and capital C is a convex subset of a linear space N, then prove that T capital C is also convex solution. First, let x comma y belongs to k plus l. Therefore, there are small k1, k2 belongs to capital K, l1 small, l2 small belongs to capital L, such that x is equal to k1 plus l1, y is equal to k2 plus l2. Now, for any alpha belongs to closed interval 0, 1, that is, you can write as, therefore, alpha x plus 1 minus alpha y can be written as equal to alpha x k1 plus l1 plus 1 minus alpha y k2 plus l2. Regrouping alpha k1 plus 1 minus alpha k2 plus alpha l1 plus 1 minus alpha l2. Note it. It can be written as equal to 3 plus l3, where k3 is equal to alpha k1 plus 1 minus alpha k2 belongs to convex set K. L3 is equal to alpha L1 plus 1 minus alpha L2 belongs to convex set L. This implies alpha X plus 1 minus alpha Y also belongs to K plus L. This implies K plus L is also convex, hence the solution. Second part, let any x comma y belongs to, then there exists c1 comma c2 belongs to convex set C, such that x is equal to and y is equal to. Now, for alpha belongs to closed interval 0, 1, we have alpha x plus 1 minus alpha y equal to alpha x t c1 plus 1 minus alpha y t c2. As t is a linear transformation, so it can be written as combined condition alpha c1 plus 1 minus alpha c2. Note it, because t is linear transformation, or t is linear, it can be written as T C3, where C3 is equal to alpha C1 plus 1 minus alpha C2 belongs to convex set C. So this implies alpha X plus 1 minus alpha Y belongs to convex set C. This implies convex set C is also convex. Hence the solution.